Hello folks, good to see you all. And first let me introduce myself. My name is Kevin Chandrikola and I'm from Management D class, Faculty of Economics at Semarang State University. And today I'm gonna do my reading practice assignment for English class. And I'm gonna presenting reading a text about the greatest military general of all time. Let's check it out. Preliminary. When we think about the greatest military general of all time, who we will think about? Is it Julius Caesar, Alexander the Great, or even our second former president, Mr. Suharto? It's not. The number one spot for the greatest military general of all time belongs to the Emperor of France, Napoleon Bonaparte. Napoleon is the greatest tactical general of all time, and the math proves it. Napoleon's early life. Napoleon was born on 15 August 1769 at Ajaccio, Corsica Island, part of the Kingdom of France. When he turned 9 years old, he moved to the French mainland and enrolled at a religious school in Autun in January 1779. In May, he transferred with a scholarship to a military academy at Brienne-le-Château, and with his study at the military academy, that's where all the story began. Early career, Napoleon's first war campaign. 2 days after the marriage, Bonaparte left Paris to take command of the army of Italy. He immediately went on the offensive, hoping to defeat the forces of Piedmont before the Austrian allies could intervene. In a series of rapid victories during the Montenotte campaign, he knocked Piedmont out of the war in 2 weeks. The French then focused on the Austrian for the remainder of the war, the highlight of which became the protracted struggle for Mantua. The Austrians launched a series of offensives against the French to break the siege, but Napoleon defeated every relief effort, scoring victories at the battles of Castiglione, Bassiano, Arcole, and Rivoli. The decisive French triumph at Rivoli in January 1797 led to the collapse of the Austrian position in Italy. At Rivoli, the Austrians lost up to 14,000 men, while the French lost about 5,000. The next phase of the campaign featured the French invasion of the Habsburg heartlands. French forces in southern Germany had been defeated by the Archduke Charles in 1796, but the Archduke withdrew his forces to protect Vienna after learning about Napoleon's assault. In the first encounter between the two commanders, Napoleon pushed back his opponents and advanced deep into Austrian territory after winning at the Battle of Tarvis in March 1797. The Austrians were alarmed by the French thrust that reached all the way to Leoben, about 100 km from Vienna, and finally decided to sue for peace. The Treaty of Leoben, followed by the more comprehensive Treaty of Campo Formio, gave France control of the most of northern Italy and the Low Countries, and a secret clause promised the Republic of Venice to Austria. Ruler of French Republic. How Napoleon can become an emperor of France? Napoleon drew together an alliance with director Emmanuel Joseph Sieyès, his brother Lucien, speaker of the Council of 500 Roger Ducos, director Joseph Fouché, and Talleyrand. But they overthrew the directory by coup d'état on 9 November 1799, closing down the Council of 500. Napoleon became first consul for 10 years, with two consuls appointed by him who had consultative voices only. His power was confirmed by the new Constitution of the Year 8, originally devised by Sieyès to give Napoleon a minor role, but rewritten by Napoleon and accepted by direct popular vote. 3 million in favor and 1,567 opposed. The constitution preserved the appearance of a republic, but in reality established a dictatorship. Assassination attempt. There are some people who are not happy to see Napoleon as a ruler of French Republic. During the consulate, Napoleon faced several royalist and Jacobin assassination plots, including the conspiration des Poignards, or dagger plot in October 800, and the plot of the Rue Saint-Nicaise, also known as the Infernal Machine, 2 months later. In January 1804, his police uncovered an assassination plot against him that involved Murat and which was ostensibly sponsored by the Bourbon family, the former rulers of France. Emperor of France. Napoleon's coronation as an Emperor of French Republic. To expand his power, Napoleon used these assassination plots to justify the creation of an imperial system based on the Roman model. He believed that the Bourbon restoration would be more difficult if his family succession was entrenched in the constitution. Launching yet another referendum, Napoleon was elected as Emperor of the French by a tally exceeding 99%. As with the Life Consulate 2 years earlier, this referendum produced heavy participation, bringing out almost 3.6 million voters to the polls. Napoleon's coronation, at which Pope Pius VII officiated, took place at Notre Dame de Paris on 2 December 1804. Two separate crowns were brought for the ceremony, a golden laurel wreath recalling the Roman Empire, and a replica of Charlemagne's crown. He created 18 marshals of the empire from among his top generals to secure the allegiance of the army on 18 May 1804, the official start of the empire. The master of the continent. It's all about Napoleon's glory, just that. Not without a reason, French is called the master of the continent. This is because Napoleon managed to achieve various strategic victories in the war he faced, even though Napoleon's loss in number of troops. His genius in war strategy earned him the title of the best military general of all time. Napoleon won the war from the First Coalition until Fifth Coalition without any single defeat. Just imagine, French Republic alone fighting the Great Britain, Russian Empire, the Holy Roman Empire, Austrian Empire, and Prussian Empire, and actually winning it all. This track record really proves Napoleon's capacity in war strategy. The War of the Third Coalition was Napoleon at his best. He defeated 15,000 coalition soldiers at Austerlitz battle with only 8,500 French soldiers. The end of an era. Napoleon always won all the war he faced. However, he's still a human being who make mistakes. At the great invasion of Russian empires, Napoleon and Europe's army of coalition had to achieve great casualties and loss. And that's where Napoleon began to lose his power over Europe. He also losing the War of the Sixth Coalition. In the Treaty of Fontainebleau, the Allies exiled Napoleon to Elba, an island of 12,000 inhabitants in the Mediterranean, 20 kilometers off the Tuscan coast. They gave him sovereignty over the island and allowed him to retain the title of emperor. Napoleon attempted suicide with the pill he had carried after nearly being captured by Russians during the retreat from Moscow. Its potency had weakened with age, however, and he survived to be exiled, while his wife and son took refuge in Austria. Okay guys, that's all I can present to you. Hope you enjoy the video. Thank you for watching and see you all on another chance. Goodbye folks, and out.